I study the DOC, the dissolved organic carbon. There is as much DOC in the ocean as there is carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So you can't see it, obviously, it's just dissolved, just like you would take a spoonful of sugar and dissolve it in a cup of water. That essentially is dissolved organic carbon. So all of that DOC in the ocean, we don't really know that much about it, because unlike sugar, which is just one compound that we can very easily characterize, we don't really know what DOC is. It's a mixture of thousands of different things. And we're just now getting the capability to actually characterize it analytically.
Yeah, so this is a model that we have set up for Chesapeake and Delaware Bay, kind of this big section of the mid-Atlantic. We will use this, which predicts the salinity, temperature, as well as the actual ocean currents, you know, tides, that sort of thing, to drive what we would call a biogeochemical model. So what is that? It's an ecosystem model. So I'm actually working on, this is just the physics, what we would call temperature, salinity, movement, and I'm currently working on everything else that comes from that, so all the biology and the chemistry that would also be in the system.
So this large, this huge pool of organic carbon, we want to understand how long it's going to stay that way, how is it changing over time, because if there's a very small change in that pool that causes some of it to go back to CO2, like for instance, when the oceans warm up, then that could sort of exacerbate the problem of global warming.